Hey Vsauce, I'm Jake, and whether you like Call of Duty or not, the fact is, it's incredibly popular. The latest game in the series, Black Ops 2, has over 916 million hours played, which is a little more than 104,000 years. 83,000 people die every minute in the game, which would mean that in 6 days, there would be nobody left in the world. In total, there are over 106 billion deaths in Black Ops 2, which is equivalent to 98% of humans who have ever existed. But out of the 916 million hours of gameplay, what if just one was real? As in, real people, real weapons, and real costs. Since parts of the game take place in the future with equipment that doesn't exist, we will stick to items that are used today in combat. Like the most heavily used assault rifle in the US Armed Forces, the M4 Carbine, which costs $673 a piece, and the 5.56 millimeter round it uses at 26 cents a cartridge. Then the cost of basic training for a soldier, which is around $50,000. Now let's start small with the ammunition. The US Army used 1.5 billion rounds of small arms ammo for all of 2006. In Call of Duty, an average 88 million shots are fired an hour, so you'd hit 1.5 billion before the end of the day. But in terms of cost, those 88 million rounds would be $22,800,000. Their weight alone is about the same as the Eiffel Tower, on top of another Eiffel Tower. Then let's say you get a killstreak and call in some cruise missiles. The Tomahawk missile is one of the most commonly used, and the tactical version costs $1.45 million per shot. Not to mention that you need something to launch it, like a $2 billion submarine or a $4.5 billion destroyer. But let's make it simple and use the 20,209 people playing Black Ops 2 on Steam right now as our army sample size. How much would it cost to get them battle ready and equipped for a 1 hour long fight? Well, at $50,000 per soldier for training, plus around $17,400 to equip a soldier with a weapon, body armor, and necessary gear, with those two factors alone, we are looking at least $1,362,086,600 for 1 hour of war, which compared to the $300 million the United States spends a day on the war in Iraq and Afghanistan is pretty incredible. Currently, in Black Ops 2, there have been over 1.9 trillion shots fired, and if they were all at the standard weight of one 5.56 millimeter round, it would weigh about 362 billion kilograms, or 6% the weight of Earth. Now, how would we actually fund an hour of warfare that costs $1,362,000,000? If you take the 22.9 million copies of the game sold worldwide, with each unit at the retail price of $60, it would equal $1,374,000,000, which would be enough to pay for 1 hour of real-life Call of Duty, and give you $14 million left over to buy almost 10 tactical Tomahawk missiles. But when buying games like Call of Duty, are we actually giving money to gun manufacturers? My friend Mike Rugnetta on the PBS Idea channel made a great video discussing just that. Be sure to check it out, and as always, thanks for watching.